going to be talking a little bit about this stuff here. And I heard you talking about it. What is this black stuff? What is it?
Coal.
And why is coal so important? Any ideas? Because it lights fire. What else would we use coal for? Well done. It helps work machines in factories and places like that. So somebody said it can keep you warm, was it this side? Work machines, what else would we use coal for? Any ideas? Right at the back. Come on then. Yeah. For what?
Electricity.
Well, electricity, yeah, coal. That's more in the modern world, but we're going back about 100 odd years. Why would coal be so important? So we've got it for fuel in the house. Factories. Brilliant! He's got it. Transport for steam trains. So coal was really important. Now, was it safe to go underground to get coal? It was a very, very dangerous job for men and boys. And we're going to talk a little bit about the Felling Mine disaster, which has gone back one time, hasn't it?
No.
Right. We're going to talk about 92 men and boys lost their lives underground in an explosion. Does anybody know what sort of stuff causes those explosions underground? Any ideas? You might have certainly guessed at school, I think a little bit talk about it. Yeah? The coal dust, yeah? Anything else?
Lava.
Oh, not lava. Oh, what's your name? Speak up!
Lucy.
Lucy said gas. That is perfect. We've got two dangers underground. We've got the gas, which is methane gas, and we've got the dust, the coal dust, which can trigger explosions. So where do you think all this methane comes from? Underground, where do you think it comes from? Here, Clue, give you a clue. Yeah? Coal, of course it does. The methane gas comes from coal. And of course, what's the other danger underground? You need your sunglasses on the ground?
No.
What's the danger?
Fire.
Fire, but what about what? Yeah?
Darkness.
Darkness. So we need some form of light. And men and boys would use candles to light the way. And they would be making pay for themselves, you know. We don't provide it free. Don't run a charity, you know. So yes, we've got naked flames to see. It was really dangerous on the ground. So, this explosion, it drew the attention, right, to need some form of safety lamp underground. Using a candle isn't safe, is it? We need some sort of safety lamp. This is Nani's impression of that explosion. It was horrendous. It turned day to night. There was that much dust and muck in the atmosphere. It could be heard all around the valley. The blast totally destroyed all the headgear and everything at the top. It was horrible, right? So something needed to be done to make it safe, right? So the two things that we're going to investigate is, we've already mentioned the young lady here wears our methane person, and our coal person this side. So we'll demonstrate methane first. Methane is a gas that builds up underground. This is a big word. It's flammable. What does that mean? And here, hands up, what does flammable mean? Who said that? Yeah, it means it burns. It burns very, very easily. And we're going to do a demonstration of a gas explosion in the ground. Now listen, this is important, right? There may be a little bit of a flash and a bang. Teachers, right? I had two teachers crying earlier on. I don't want any of the teachers. The kids are all right, but I had a couple of teachers crying. So just be aware of what's coming. Is that okay? Right, so this here is my mine. Underground, it could be a tunnel like that, or it could be a tunnel going vertical. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a little bit of chemical in here. Right, like this. Now this chemical is going to change from a liquid to a gas. So we put that liquid in there. There we go. Put my gloves on. And we're going to shake it. I could do the dag dance now. Right, when the liquid changes to a gas, it does something. It's said to do what? Come on, hands up, don't shout out. When a liquid changes to a gas, it's said to do what? Come on, all your hands should be up. Let's get a teacher to pick someone. Should get a teacher to pick someone. Right, if you haven't got your hands up, by the way, I'll pick you. Come on, what's it said to do? What am I doing? I'm shaking this, and it's changing from a liquid to a gas. It's said to do what? Okay then, this young chap with the blue top on. Who's daydreaming? Yeah. What's it said to do? Get your hand up if you forgot.
Take it.
It said to what?
Oh, take it.
No. Good try. Anybody else? Pick somebody teach. No. When a liquid changes shape state to a gas, you lean in the red spots. Oh! Top of the class! It's said to evaporate. That's what we're making. The liquid is evaporating and making a gas in here. Do you all agree? Is she right?
Yes.
Right. It's going. Right, now what we've done, we have filled this container with now a flammable gas. Uh-oh. And we're going to get our little trapper. What's your name right there? Shout!
Lincoln!
He's working underground at the bottom there. And Lincoln's in here with his candle lit.
Now I'm in. Glasses on.
Front row! Will you put your safety glasses on? Have you not brought them? Right, what you need to do is put your fingers over your eyebrows. At least it'll save your eyebrows. Right, so. Here we go, let's see what happens. I'm going to do it now. Don't panic, you're alright. Perfectly safe. The flames went to atmosphere, they vented, but underground that was trapped, and that would go that way down the mine, it would go that way down the mine, and it would be destroying anything that's there, but it would also lift up all the dust, right? And dust's inflammable, and it would set off a second explosion, a more, that was dangerous, wasn't it? But it would set a more violent explosion off. It would trigger a dust explosion. I'm going to demonstrate that to you in a second. Is that okay?
Yeah!
All the teachers, are you teachers all right?
Yeah.
Yes. Teachers trying to
learn. None this time. None this time.
So. Right. What we've got here. Right. Okay, what's that? Oh, you've got another lamp coming. Right, what the gentleman's got here is a, I don't know if you can see this, it's two mines rescue team, isn't it? Going underground. Modern, because they've got the breathing apparatus sets on. Right. So the mines rescue have their own teams to go down after explosions or gas or anything like that. And that's a little model of them underground, the modern ones. Of course, in the past, we didn't have that sort of thing, did we? And you know that. Thank you. Right, so we'll show you what the mines rescue teams have put up with. This is going to be a dust explosion. There we go. Right, imagine now this is our mine shaft down here. Right, mine shaft. So the cage is going up and down like that, and the men and boys are going to work and cold thing lifted out. And we've got, who am I picking on now? Who am I picking on now? What's your name there, Colin? Yeah? Benjamin! Right, Benjamin, how old are you?
10.
He's the noisy age, 9 and 10. Benjamin's 10, so he's old enough to work underground now. And his job underground, he's a little trapper boy. Oh. And his job is to open and close doors and let people through. And you've got a nice little candle so you can see what you're doing, isn't that nice? It's a lovely job, he's just studying out of the school. And unfortunately, Benjamin, a bit of dust spilled in. We've got special stuff here. This is our coal dust. It's a bit cleaner than normal coal dust, but it burns exactly the same. So we're going to get a little bit of dust going down the mine shaft, and we've got our little man in the corner with his candle there. Let's see what happens when the dust burns up. Straight up there, we're in a mine, it'll go underground as well, both ways. And as it's pushing along, it'll build up more and more pressure, destroying everything. Dust explosions were horrendous. Now, would you like me to do another one?
Yeah!
I'll take that as a no. Last one, I'm just going to go one in a sec. Okay, what should I do now? Everything has to be like a seesaw. Everything has to be in balance. If it's not in balance, then nothing will happen. The tragedies happen when that dust is in balance, when there's enough air and dust, there's not too much to cause those explosions. So we'll do one more, and then we'll try and see what the solution is. Something must be done to make the mine safer. We must do something. And what happened was he went to the mine owners and spoke to them. And you know what they wanted to know? Nothing. They weren't interested. It's a dangerous job going down the mine. That was their outlook. And they said, basically, it's none of your business. Right, you do the preaching, Vicar. We'll look after the miners. And he said, no, something's got to be done. So he set a committee up. They raised £2,000 as a prize for somebody who could come up with a safe way of lighting underground the mine. And as it was, there was men working on the project at the time, coming up with different ideas. One of them was William Reed Clanning. He was a local doctor, and he actually tracked a lot of the people who were burnt in mine accidents. And he came up with an idea of how to light the mine. And it was a candle that was encased inside that tube there. And one person worked a set of bellows, pumped air in, and that kept the candle burning, and the air vented out through the water at the top, so it was like a water valve. And he would pump away merrily, another person would hold it, and it took three people to operate that. So was that really feasible, three people to work a candle underground? No. But what he did prove was, right, he proved that a flame can be taken underground safely, not trigger an explosion. Now our next engineer, have you heard of George Stevenson? Yes! Oh, a local engineer, they're all going here. George Stevenson, he came up with the idea of wrapping a candle around the doors. This stuff here, that's a drawing of his first invention. This is gauze here, have you seen it? This stuff. Some in secondary school I think they use this still. But the gauze can hold the flame back. Can we prove this? Turn that on. Right. So, there's my gauze. I'm going to put it over the flame. What do you think is going to happen? Let's see. Has the flame come through? Oh, it's come through. So what should I do now? Try and stop it. Put another one on. Let's see what happens now. Is that going to hold the flame back, do you think? Or can the flame come through? It's not coming through, you know. It's holding it back. Now what's happening is the gauze is absorbing all that heat. And it's holding the flame back. It's locking it back. And that's what he designed there, right? Was a gauze, a candle inside a gauze, and that protected it. That stopped the reaction. Let's do another bit experimenting. Right, so, light your candle. Yeah. It's a gauze held the flame back and did its job. The answer was the gauze. And even in modern times, until quite recently, mine's safety lamps were similar to this. They had a gauze inside. Now they are electronic. But that is just a tiny, tiny bit of history about the mine's safety lamp, known as the Davy lamp. Now, unfortunately, I'm running out of time. You're next. Is it group time next, I think?